Hello everyone, in this session we will see what is a purchase journal, purchase day book, what is a purchase returns day book. So let's begin. Purchase journal book. All the credit purchases of goods are recorded in purchase journal book. So only credit purchases of goods are recorded in purchase journal book. Cash purchases of goods are recorded in cash book. So whatever are the cash purchases, they are recorded in the cash book. Other purchases such as purchase of furniture, building, stationery, etc. are recorded in journal proper if it is on credit basis, and if it is purchased for cash, then it is recorded in cash book. Now furniture, building are fixed assets. So purchase of fixed assets, if they are on credit basis, they are recorded in journal proper. If it is on cash basis, then it is recorded in cash book. Stationery is again not a goods. So purchase of stationery is recorded in journal proper if it is on credit basis, and if the stationery is purchased for cash, then it is recorded in cash book. There may be numerous transactions of purchase of goods on day-to-day basis, especially in the large businesses. So instead of passing a separate journal entry for each transaction, it is recorded in purchase journal. So purchase journal is also known as purchase day book. Say if I have a business and I have an average of 1000 purchase transactions in a day. So passing a separate journal entry for each and every transaction will be tedious. So instead of that, I will be writing these details in the purchase journal book. The purchase journal contains details of every credit purchases of goods like date, name of supplier, invoice number, amount. The amount recorded in purchase journal is the net amount in the invoice, that is after deducting a trade discount. So basically every credit purchase is recorded in purchase journal along with its invoice details and the amount. The amount will be after deducting your trade discounts. Entries in the purchase book may be posted daily, weekly, fortnightly or monthly in purchases account on debit side. Say I have a business wherein I have thousands of purchase transactions on a daily basis. So what I do, each transaction is recorded in the purchase journal. Then the total of the day is posted in the purchases account on the debit side. Now that total may be posted either daily, weekly, fortnightly or monthly depending on the policy of the company. Entries may be posted to individual suppliers account daily. So what is a entry for purchases? Entry for the purchases will be your purchases account debit to creditor account. So the creditor account has to be credited with the purchases amount. So those individual suppliers, entry for those individual suppliers may be posted daily in individual suppliers account. Whereas the entries from purchase book to purchases account may be either posted daily, weekly, fortnightly or monthly depending on the policy of the company. Let's see this in detail. This is a purchase journal book. You have date, invoice number, name of supplier, voucher number, amount. This is a purchase account. Now, purchases account is a ledger account in the books of accounts. So we have debit, credit. We have date, particular, voucher number, amount. Date, particular, voucher number, amount. The periodical total is posted in purchases account on daily, weekly, fortnightly or monthly basis depending on the policy. So each and every credit purchase is first recorded in the purchase journal book. Then the periodical total, it may be on daily basis or on weekly basis, or fortnightly is 15 days or monthly is once in a month. So that periodical total is posted in the purchases account on the debit side. Now let's see what is a purchase returns journal. purchase returns book. All the purchase returns, whether it is for cash purchases or credit purchases, are recorded in purchase returns book. So in case of purchase journal, it was only for credit purchase. But for purchase returns book, all your purchase returns, whether the original purchase was on cash basis or credit basis, all your purchase returns will be recorded in purchase return journal or purchase return day book. The purchase return journal contains details of all purchase returns of goods like date, name of supplier, invoice number, amount. The amount recorded in purchase journal is net amount in the invoice. So the purchase return also contains the similar details like that of your purchase journal, and the amount recorded is a net amount in the invoice, that is after deducting your trade discount. Entries from purchase return journal are posted wherein the supplier's account is debited and the purchase return account is credited with periodical total. Now, the purchase return entry, what will be the purchase return entry? It will be reverse of your purchase entry. So the entry will be your supplier's or creditor's account debit to purchase return. So in case of purchase return, all the purchase return are recorded in your purchase return day book, and the individual supplier's account is debited on day-to-day basis. Whereas your purchase return account, that is a ledger account, is credited with a periodical total of your purchase return book. It may be either on daily basis, weekly basis, or fortnightly basis, or monthly basis. The source document for recording purchase return is a debit note. So for recording a purchase return, the source document is debit note. Now let us understand the process of purchase returns. This is a business. This is supplier of the goods. So we are returning the purchased goods to the supplier. And along with that, we will be debiting the supplier's account. So we will issue a debit note to suppliers along with the goods. For supplier, it is sales return. So supplier will be crediting our account in his books and send us a credit note. So we will be sending a debit note along with the goods to the supplier, and the supplier will be sending us the credit note. So the source document for recording purchase return is a debit note. Now let us understand what is a debit note and credit note in detail. Debit note. When other's party account is debited other than for credit sale, then the debit note is prepared and sent to the other party. So when we debit any party's account for some purpose other than the credit sale, then we prepare a debit note and send it to the other party saying that your account is debited by so and so amount. Let us look at the format of debit note. So name and the address of the company, debit note, date, against, we have supplier's name and address here, details of goods return with amount and invoice number, delivery challan number, and signature of authorized person. This is a format of debit note. Credit note. When other party's account is credited other than for credit purchases, then the credit note is prepared and sent to the other party. Just opposite of your debit note is a credit note. When we credit other's account except for the credit purchases, then the credit note is prepared and sent to the other party saying that your account is credited by so and so amount. Let's see the format of credit note. We have name and address of the company, credit note, date, against, in that we have customer's name and address, details of the goods returned with invoice number and amount, delivery challan number, signature of authorized persons. Now let's see the format of purchase returns book. We have date, invoice number, name of supplier, voucher number, amount. This is similar to your purchase book. Then we have purchase returns account, which is our ledger account in the books, debit, credit, date, particular voucher number, amount, date, particular voucher number, amount. The periodical total is posted in purchase returns account on daily, weekly, fortnightly or monthly basis depending on the policy. So this was about your purchase journal and purchase returns book. They are also known as purchase day book and purchase returns day book.